Mother Teresa is most famous for her ceaseless efforts to help the destitute people of Calcutta in India, where she first started her mission work. Yet on her visit here, she toured some of the streets in London's West End where the down-and-outs and the homeless sleep during the night. Deeply distressed by what she'd seen, Mother Teresa returned to one of the three houses her order has in London. Here she spent much of the day in prayer and contemplation, which always occupy many hours of her working day. But particularly busy though her schedule is, she took a little of her precious time to talk to me before she went to see the Prime Minister tonight. I asked her first about her impressions of the homeless in London.
I never compare. Each place, each person is something special for me. So each one I take separately, as Jesus in their distress in disguise.
What are your feelings towards those people who are homeless and sleep in the streets here?
I'm very anxious to get a place where we can bring them and give them a nice, good shelter and make them feel wanted, loved, cared, that they are somebody special.
You're going to see Mrs. Thatcher this evening?
I'm hoping to ask her to give us a house.
Will you also be asking her to do anything else to help the homeless?
No, I don't think. I think this is something to begin with it first. What is this? And then, I don't know what she's going to ask also. I will have to answer according what she will ask.
Yeah. Is there anything that you will be asking her?
No, I mean, I'm very concerned for this because we are very anxious to do something immediately for our people.
You've been an inspiration to many people who help desolate and people throughout the world. What is it that God has given you that makes you able to do this?
We have a very deep life of prayer. And so the fruit of prayer is all this. Without that, I don't think I would be able to do it.
And that helps you to help other people?
To help others, yes, to bring joy and happiness. Because I'm perfectly happy. And my sisters are radiating joy also.
And you just know that this gentle and strong woman of God will continue her stubborn fight for those she feels need the love and care she and her Sisters of Charity can bring. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.